Hi friends, today we will look at the ethics question 35 that I have given yesterday. So this falls under the aptitude versus attitude part of the syllabus of ethics GS4. As it is 10 marks question, be precise at exactly what they have asked. Write short introductions and short introduction and short conclusion. And friends, in this kind of question, where they're asking you specific terms, attitude, aptitude, or maybe something as value, moral, whatever, along with defining them in your own words, also give some good examples. If you feel that giving one example is not giving any kind of clarity to the evaluator, you can actually give two, three examples also. Give short and precise examples. Also, when you define these kind of terms, try to write in your own language. Essentially, our idea is to make it easy for the evaluator to understand what we want to tell. So, the first part of the question is, what is the difference between attitude and aptitude? Second part is, which of these two is more important, either for a person or organization? So, try to write both. For person, what is more important, and for organization, what is more important. So, in the introduction, let us define what they are. So, first you can start writing saying that attitude and aptitude both are psychological traits of a person. Now, let us first define attitude. You can say that attitude is our feeling or our perception or our opinion towards any object or any person or any situation or even any idea. So how do you feel about an object, a person, a situation, idea is called attitude. Now try to give a small example. You can say that our attitude depends on the knowledge. Our knowledge towards something will decide our feeling towards it. And our feeling towards something will decide our behavior towards it. You can even draw a diagram, a chart like that. For example, you can tell that, take for example, woman. Let us discuss the attitude of male towards a female. For example, if our knowledge is that females are inferior to males and females have less physical and mental capacity, less management ability than males, then if that is our knowledge, lower abilities, there is a knowledge, let us say we are taught wrong knowledge, then based on that we will feel superior to men. A feeling of superiority will come automatically because that is the knowledge you have. Based on that, your behavior will come out. For example, when you work in a team with a woman, you may try to dominate the woman. You may try to dominate them. So this is called negative attitude towards women. For example, take dogs. Take a dog, okay? Let us say, your knowledge about dogs is that dogs are highly faithful animals. That is the knowledge you have regarding the dogs. Then your feeling will be low. You will love dogs. As you love dogs, your behavior will be, you'll take good care of them, you'll domesticate them. So your behavior with dogs will be more friendly. So this is a positive attitude towards animals. This is negative attitude towards women. So you can just draw a chart, no need to explain much. So with the example, you can, finish what you want to explain regarding attitude to the evaluator. Now come to aptitude. You define aptitude. You can say that aptitude is a skill. Is a skill towards doing any kind of work, a kind of skill or competence. You can also call competence towards doing any work. For example, take a boxer. A boxer requires both mental aptitude as well as physical aptitude, the type of punches that he throws, physical aptitude, skill that he requires regarding the boxing. Or take, for example, a doctor. A doctor needs certain aptitude while making surgeries, or she needs certain skill in the medical field, he or she. So that is called aptitude. Now, as we define both of them, now we can tell the differences between both of them, differences, which is asked in the question. You can say that aptitude can be trained. For example, if you want to become a good boxer, somebody can train you, teach you the skill of boxing. If you want to become a good doctor, they can train you in the medical science. However, attitude will not come by training. Attitude means your perception towards object, ideas, whatever, will not come with training. it comes with self-motivation. Means you have to motivate the people or students to develop right attitude. It will not just come from the classes. Similarly, another difference is attitude is only mental. How you feel about objects or things is mental. Whereas aptitude is both physical as well as mental. Your aptitude is both physical as well as mental. For example, take a doctor. A doctor requires deep knowledge in medical science as well as require the skills of surgery, which is physical in nature. That's another difference. Another one is your attitude will tell your character. For example, my attitude towards women, towards elders, towards children, towards some ideas, objects, situations. Based on that, you can decide my character. Whereas aptitude means the skill cannot tell about your character. That's the next difference. One more thing is your aptitude can be quantified. For example, you can give an example also. CAT exam, Common Aptitude Test, is an exam conducted for selecting the management graduates into top colleges of India, top management colleges of India. So where they are quantifying your aptitude by giving reasoning or English comprehension, where they are testing the students whether they have got good reasoning ability, good speed reading ability, which are required for a manager. So like that, aptitude can be quantified. Whereas attitude, you cannot measure with numbers, you cannot quantify it. And the difference is, our attitude means our perception towards different objects, things, people will be decided by the society and media. Means at least they will affect society and media has great effect on our attitude. Whereas our aptitude cannot be decided by the media or society mostly. So these are some of the differences. You can write more differences if you want, but we have to keep it short as it's 10 marks question. Then the second part of the question, which is more important. I would suggest to you that generally in this kind of questions, try to be neutral. Tell that both are equally important. And in conclusion, if you want, you can say that something is slightly more important than the other. But don't say that something is waste. For example, don't tell that aptitude is not at all required. It is only attitude that decides the life. Don't write this kind of extreme statements. So now, here also, while telling which is important, whether attitude or aptitude, which is important, it is better you give examples to convince the evaluator that you have a logic behind it. So first, I would say both are important. I'm not saying both are equally important. I'm simply saying both attitude and aptitude are important. Give an example. For example, doctor requires good aptitude. He or she requires good knowledge or medical skills or surgery skills. At the same time, they also require good attitude towards the patients. A doctor which can, you know, look at the patients with love and affection, who actually cares for the patients, who has a positive attitude towards the patient, will become a successful doctor. So both attitude, both are required. Come to software engineer. A software engineer definitely requires good aptitude. Aptitude means good coding skills. At the same time, he requires good attitude towards the company, towards the colleagues, so that he can work in a team. Because a software engineer alone cannot finish a project. He requires good teamwork. So he requires good attitude towards the colleagues or fellow beings about the project, about the campaign. Only then he can successfully fit in the company. In that way, I can give two examples to explain that both are important. However, it's better to tell situations where only aptitude is there, but attitude is not there. For example, as the question is asking about a person, an organization, you give both examples. You can say that, take a student. A student has got good aptitude. He has got good knowledge in mathematics and science, good writing skills. However, the student could not clear particular examination, certain competitive examination. Some of the students we see are committing suicides. When they could not succeed in the examination, they are committing suicides, which means they have got negative attitude towards life. So, though they have good aptitude, if they do not have good attitude, their life actually is getting ruined. Another example, for example, take an organization. Take Satyam. Satyam scandal, you may be knowing Satyam scandal. So Satyam organization has hired good employees who have got good aptitude, very good aptitude. But the organization as a whole do not have the right outlook towards the project society. So they actually produce false documentation, false financial, balance sheets to the auditors, because of which finally they were caught. And it actually ruined not only the organization's pride, but also it costed the jobs of several employees. In that way, you can give examples of how a person organization having good aptitude but wrong attitude will fail. Another example, a person having good attitude but wrong aptitude, now what would you say about such people? You can say that a student who is having right attitude, he is respecting teachers, is ready to work hard, and he is humble, you know, such a kind of student, even if he is poor in mathematics or sciences, he can be trained. You have to find out a method of training him so that he can learn them. So a student having right attitude but wrong aptitude, his life may not be ruined if you can train him properly in that way. So as a conclusion, you can say that life, the success in life depends on 80% attitude and 20% aptitude. Like that, you can write some meaningful sentence. Or you can say, the education system of India or anywhere should include not only developing the aptitude, but also developing the right attitude by motivation. Or you can say statements like, the attitude of a company and its employees depends on the attitude of the management. In this way, you can actually conclude. Just write what sentences, meaningful sentences, to get more marks. Okay, friends, coming to the question for tomorrow. As today we finish GS4, naturally, as per cycle, we will go to GS1 for tomorrow. And I am giving question which is a combination of world history and post-independence history of India. So the question is about what happened between last two decades of 20th century and how it influenced India. See you, friends. Take care.